And then now we have S to S, meaning to say with the same thing, right? And then this is S prime to S prime. So we have a representation A, we have a representation B, we have a transition matrix from S prime to S, but then that transition matrix from S prime to S is also P. Following this general diagram here, then what should B look like? Here. B will represent the same transformation if you can, there's this thing that exists, an unsingular matrix P, such that that's P inverse AP. Maybe we don't need to give an example of that. It's the same story, right?
No. I watch your videos while I watch your videos.
No, but this is okay now, right? We can skip this. Can we? Huh?
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Is that PQ? There's only one.
There's only one, right? No, Brea, you're joking, right? You know how to do it.
Because I'm not even taking you seriously.
All right. Now let's go back to the story of the eigen. Now it's 7. Can we move on to 7? Right?
Let's do it.
So now in 7.1, we started talking of the eigenvalues.
So didn't you say we were going to look at a specific problem and then...
This one. We'll follow the same guy.
Oh, we're following that same...
The same guy. Okay. Eigenvalues and eigenvectors. I don't know if it will behave nicely. Probably. Okay, let's see.
Let's cross our fingers.
So eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So... let's see if we can follow the same thing if we have P1 to P1, right? Where the story is, it takes AT plus B to BT plus A, right? Does anybody remember the definition of an eigenvalue?
An eigenvalue was...
in general, if you have L from B to B, right? And it has to be a transformation from... a vector space into itself, correct? Okay? What happens is what? If you take any vector here, I think we called it V. Did we call it V or S? If we take a little V here, it should go to a lambda V. I thought we were calling it X also somehow, okay? Meaning to say what? Meaning to say that pictorially, what you, geometrically, what you imagine is what? If this is vector V, it's just mapped to what? It's just a scalar multiple of itself or something parallel to itself, right? You understand? Okay. So what we said was what? What was the shortcut of finding this? So we wanted the eigenvalues would be L of V is equal to lambda V, right? But then we said that because L can be represented by a matrix, right?
Yeah.
We really said that what? This can be written as A, correct?
AV
is equal to lambda V, correct? And then from here, I messed up last time, I made the, okay. I can write this as lambda I V minus AV, correct? So we said that this is the same as finding the solution of lambda I minus A times V. We end up solving a homogeneous system, correct? For all the lambdas. All right, so how exactly does that work? We need a matrix. What matrix did we get from before? Give me one that we...
1, 2, 3, 4.
No, the one that for this guy that we found. What was the standard matrix that we found? Maybe that's not a good example. Use one. No, we just did it earlier. The discussion that we had.
Just always B from last
one. Which one? The B? Could you give me a matrix?
0, 1, 0.
0, 1, 0, 1.
Oh, why do you like this ugly one? Didn't we have something that had like a nicer values?
Yeah, 0, 1, 1, 0.
I don't know if this is exact. 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, right? Okay, that's the matrix A. So what we said last meeting was to find the eigenvalues of this, it really boils down to finding what? The characteristic polynomial. What was the characteristic polynomial? It was the determinant of lambda I minus A, right? This was the characteristic polynomial, and we set this equal to 0. Why did we want to set this equal to 0? Do you guys remember? Because?
So we can solve for lambda.
Because the only way, this is a homogeneous system, right? This is a homogeneous system. The reason we're setting the determinant of the coefficient matrix equal to zero is because? Because you want the coefficient matrix tag to be singular. Why do we want the coefficient matrix to be singular? So that we can find what? So we can find what? Some non-trivial solution, right? This one, the eigenvectors, right? Okay. So the only way for you to be able to find something that goes to its own scalar multiple is homogeneous system, coefficient matrix. These are your arguments, right? These are your arguments that you will say, okay? Coefficient matrix lambda I minus A has to be singular, right? Because if it's non-singular, the only solution you'll get is what? If it's non-singular, the only solution you'll get is trivial, then that doesn't help, right? So then, for this to be singular, that means to say the determinant of lambda I minus A has to be zero. So we solve this, okay? And we say that this really looks easy. It's going to be what? Lambda minus zero, right? Minus one, correct? Minus one, lambda. Did you guys understand where I got this from? Lambda I minus A, right? You get this determinant, set that equal to zero. What is this determinant equal to? It's lambda squared minus one. Therefore, you get two answers for lambda. Lambda is what? Plus or minus one. Get it? Okay. So then what did we do after getting the eigenvalues? So these numbers are eigenvalues. The next task was to find the what? Eigenvectors. Okay, how did we find the eigenvectors? You have to solve now the homogeneous system, right? This homogeneous system, correct? Or what do you do really? You look at this. This is like your coefficient matrix, plug in lambda there. Do you guys understand why I'm pointing here? That's what the coefficient matrix looks like, right? So when lambda is 1, that's the eigenvalue. You'll have 1, negative 1, negative 1, 1. Solve this. So I don't need to pivot, right? I was about to pivot and I said, gee, I don't think you need that.
Just add them.
You see it right away. You only have two components you're looking at. So you already see the relationship that the first is the negative of the second. The first is the same as the second. So actually here, your eigenvectors will look like RR, right? Correct?
Yes.
Obvious RR, okay? But we only want one, right? So therefore we can pick what?
1, 1.
So we pick an eigenvector 1, 1. That's one eigenvector. For that, the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equals 1. The next should do lambda equals negative 1. So you solve the system where you just replace this by negative 1. So you have negative 1, negative 1, negative 1, negative 1. And again, what relationship do you see? You see that the solutions to this will look like what? R, negative R, negative R, R, right? Correct? Where R is real. We want one eigenvector, so that's what? 1, negative 1. Then somehow my brain told me to stop and think, because I'm not thinking anymore, okay? Are these really the eigenvectors that we want?
No!
Why not? I know Rain already knows that. Actually, that's very smart, because he knew I stopped. That means I caught myself that I'm just talking without thinking, right? Okay?
I knew that.
These aren't the vectors you're looking for.
These are not the vectors we are looking for. Yes, thank you, Peter. See, you're learning how to argue. Okay. These are not the vectors we are looking for. Why? Open your eyes wide and go back to the original problem. What will the vectors look like in our particular problem? I was happy. I said, oh, 1, 1 is eigenvector. Why is that not the correct answer? Because it really should look like a polynomial, right? Because remember, because our L started from P1 to P1, and I'm giving you vectors in where? R2, correct?
Yep.
So it should be
so
t plus
really,
one.
What's the eigenvector that I want to convert
so
this back?
One.
It's
t
going
plus
to be
one.
T plus 1. But you still need that guy, right? Okay?
Yeah.
So the eigenvector you're looking for is T plus 1. Likewise here, the eigenvector you're looking for is what? T minus 1. Happy now?
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean? Okay, let's go back to the definition of eigenvector. Maybe to help carry because it's too hard here, right? So when you have L from P1 to P1, and you have AT plus B mapped to BT plus A, and you wanted, what is it? You wanted L of AT plus, I explained it better last time, now I can't think. So actually if you have one eigenvector was, what did we get? T plus 1. L of T plus 1 is going to be mapped to what? According to this, it's going to be what?
It's
the same, right?
T plus one.
T, which is the same as T plus 1.
Yeah.
So therefore, it got preserved. This corresponds to the eigenvalue lambda equals 1, right? The image of T plus 1 under L is itself, right?
Yes.
Did you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. When we do L of, what's the next eigenvector we got?
T minus 1,
the story is this will switch, right? So this is going to be negative T plus 1, correct?
Yes.
Which is really the negative of the original problem, negative T minus 1. And there, sure, do you see your lambda?
I do.
I think you got excited like that too last time, Carrie. Okay, so lambda is negative 1. Do you understand? And do you see why these are the only ones that could possibly work? Right? Well, not the only ones, but of course you can have what? 100 T plus 100, right?
Yes. It's
what else?
So
you can have negative half T, right?
Yeah.
Can it work for negative half T plus a half?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right? Do you
yeah.
guys see that?
So, Professor,